In our previous videos, we explored the tensile behavior of a base metal using Abaqus. Now, in this tutorial, we take it a step further by introducing a weld into the model. How does the presence of a weld affect the stress distribution, deformation, and failure mode? Let's walk through the full simulation process from model setup to post-processing analysis. Are you ready? Let's start. By the way, if you want to skip this tutorial and get the files instantly, just watch the pinned comment down below for the direct link. Let's start with creating part. Create part, 3D deformable solid extrusion, continue. Now we need to create bunch of lines like this. And from here, I want to add a constraint and equal length. These two, select these two and done. Now I don't need to assign the dimensions for each of them. Now this one should be 10. And if I put this value on 30, you see the other one changes as well. Then we need to create two lines like this and like this. The distance between the two must be 6 millimeters, but we need to select this value at 2. The other one must be 2 as well, so I press escape. Then we need to create arc here, select this one first, then the other one. It's the same for the other one, and that's it. Now we need to apply the equal length once more on these two, then here 12.5. then it's time to create a construction line from here to here. Now we have a line and we want to mirror this side to the other side, so left click and hold on this one and select mirror. First we need to say copy, and we select the mirror line and we select everything, done, and boom, we have our model. Let's put this value here on 100, and that's it. Now done, the depth can be 1, and we have this material here. Now we need to create some modifications. First of all, we need to create the weld. From here, partition face sketch, select this one, done. Then we select this one. And here in the middle, we need to create a line like this and a line like this. So create one construction line here in order to make the symmetry. Here, let's say 1.5 for this one and 1.5 for this one. Now we have the weld. Let's create that, and that's it. Yeah, the weld is in the middle. Now we need to extrude them through the thickness. So left click and hold on this one and select partition cell sweep. Select this line first, done, and sweep along edge. You select this edge and create the part, and as you see, the part is created. Now we have to do that for the other one. Select this one, done, sweep along edge, and we can select this edge and create, and let's do that for this one first, done. This one, done, sweep along edge. We can select this one and create. Now it's time for the last one here, done, select this one, done, sweep along edge, and we select this edge and create partition. Now let's do it for the weld. Select this one, done, this one, and done, sweep along edge. We can select this edge. Sorry, we can select this edge and create part. This one, then we select the line, done, sweep along edge and this edge, and it is created. Now if we want to rotate the samples, we see we have the weld on the other side, we have other lines, and that's okay. Now let's go to the materials properties. To download the materials properties, let's go to the FEAmaster.com. Then from shop, go to the material property packs and select this one, add to cart. Then go to the checkout, fill everything and place the order. It's totally free. Once the order was completed, you can download this one. And I want to open this. Here we have a base metal and a weld metal materials properties. Let's start with the base metal first. So from here we go create material properties. Let's name it the base metal or BM. We need the general density, elasticity and elastic. We need plasticity and plastic. We need also damage for ductile materials here. And that's all, I think. Let's go to this file. We just hit the Control C and Control V here. For the elastic, we go here, copy and paste. For the plastic, we need to select this one and paste. And for the ductile damage, we have this one. Then we need to go to sub option and damage evolution. This should be on displacement, linear, and the value was 0.44. And okay, then okay. Now we have the base metal. It's better to copy the base metal and name it weld. Then we edit this. The density and the elastic modulus are the same and the damage evolution is different, so that's plastic properties. Delete these rows and let's go to the weld metal here and copy this one. Then we go here, simply paste it. Then we need to go to the damage evolution. This one is 42, so we can copy this one and we just paste it here. Then we need to go to the damage evolution and this value is 0.55, and we have the ductile damage, we have the density, plastic and elastic. Then okay, we have a base metal and a weld metal. Let's create the section. So create section here, we can name this BM or base metal, solid homogeneous, continue, and we need to select the base metal and okay. Now we need to create another section, we name it weld, solid homogeneous, continue, and we select weld and okay. Now we need to assign the sections. I uncheck this one in order not to create too many sets, and I select this one, then hold shift, select this one, then done. We need to select base metal for them and okay. And we have this part without the section, so I select it and done. It should be weld and done. If you want to see the differences between the materials properties or if you want to make sure that it's right, you have to go to here. Instead of property defaults, let's put this on materials. It shows that there are two different materials. If you want, you can change the colors. For instance, you can put red for this. And as you see, this one is red and this one is green. So I would like to put that on property defaults. And we need to go to the assembly. Here we can assemble the model. Part one, it can be independent as we only have just one part. Translate from here to here and done. Let's reset the view. Then we need to go to the step. We need to create a step. Step one initial must be dynamic explicit. Continue, and LGO must be on, and we go straight to the mass scaling. Here we need to use the scaling definitions below and create. Here check this one and put the value of 1E-4 and uncheck this one and done. Now this is the scaling and done. Another important thing to do is to go to the field output manager, double click on this one, come here to the state and check the status. If you don't check the status, you won't see the separation or fracture visually. So click on OK, dismiss. Now we're done with this step. Let's go to the interaction. Okay, in the interaction, we need to go to the tools and reference point to create a reference point. Let's select this one to create the RP. And from here, go to the create constraint and select coupling. Continue. You need to select the reference point first, then done. And we need to select the node region. You select this part and done everything and okay. As you see, this is coupled to the reference point. And now we're done with the interaction. Let's go to the load. Here we need to create the boundary condition. Create first one in the step initial, continue and select this part and done in CAS and okay. As you see, it is applied. Now go to the create. This one we need to create one from displacement and rotation and continue, select RP point and done. Now check everything because it is the step initial, but we need to modify that into step one and the U2 can only displace 15 millimeters. Now we're not done yet. We need to create an amplitude, otherwise there would be a problem and it won't let us complete that. And as you see here, if I click on OK, it's a explicit analysis. We need to create an amplitude. So let's click on this one, check tabular and continue. So you need to create one. This is 0, 0, press enter, 0.1, 0.1, 0.2, 0.2. And we go just like this. You can press enter every time and 1, 1, and that's the amplitude. Then click on OK. Now you need to select the amplitude, then OK. Now we're done with the load and boundary condition. Let's go to the mesh. Here in the mesh, as we selected the part independent, now we can create mesh easily. So mesh part and select, and as you see, the mesh is created. It can be better, but this is just a simple example and it has an educational purpose. So to further refine that, let's put that on 1, delete mesh and mesh it once more. Now it's better. Let's go to the job to create the job. But before creating a job, I want to ask you a favor. If you enjoyed this video so far, please drop me a comment down below. It's totally free for you, but it helps me grow and motivates me to create more contents like this. Let's go and create the job. I would like to select and create job manager. So we can name it Tensile Test Weld and continue. Okay, now that here we can submit the job easily. Let's monitor this, make sure there's no error, just ignore the warnings, they're fine. And as you see here, it says it is completed successfully, so we have to wait till the job completes. And the job is completed. Now let's go and take a look at the results. This is the result of the final state. Now if we select this one and if we go to the option, viewport and annotation option. Let's set all off, just keep the legend and okay. Now here from option and comment, we need to put this on feature edges. It is better. Now for the animation, let's put this on here and let's take a look at the animation. And as you see here is the weld. After the part subjected to the tensile test, the weld remained intact. It means the weld parameters were selected in a good way so that it has a better strength and the part is ruptured from non-welded part, which is totally fine. Right now let's go to the XY data, create XY data from ODB field output, continue, and let's put this one on unique nodal. And from here we can have U2 and we can have RF2. Here we need to select the reference point. Here we can select it and plot this. This is the plot. Let's modify that. So once more we go to the create XY data, but this one we would like to operate on XY data, and continue. Then we go to the combine. Let's select the U2, then RF2, and we need to plot the expression. Now you have the force versus displacement. It goes up, then elongates for like 5 millimeters, then drops down. A typical force displacement curve. You can also change this one to stress and strain, but you have to do that manually. In the previous videos, we explained them completely, but here from here, XY data, you can right click and edit, and you can select all of the data and you can copy and paste it in an Excel file. So make sure to see the previous video to know how to do that. And that's it. If you enjoyed this video, smash the like button and subscribe to the channel to see more videos like this. And if you want to learn tensile test simulation using Johnson quick damage, click on the video on the screen before it ends. Stay tuned.